Today's video is brought to you by my Nintendo Switch, because benchmarks are pointless and the human eye can't see past 30 frames per second anyway.
Please hang up and try again.
Hey, what's up everyone? Louis Tran here. In this video, we're gonna take a look at how a MacBook Pro 16-inch with an eGPU compares with a dedicated gaming desktop using the same graphics card. Now, this isn't gonna be another Mac versus PC video. I'm too old to engage in that kind of thing. This is more of a Windows laptop versus Windows desktop type of video, since the Mac is running the Microsoft OS natively. Damn, I'm gonna miss being able to do that when Apple completely switches to ARM. Now, if you watched my previous video, I just built my first PC in 20 years last week, and so far it has performed beautifully. Performed beautifully. Before that, I was gaming on my 16-inch MacBook Pro with an Akito Node eGPU with an NVIDIA RTX 2070 Super. Before COVID-19, I was traveling quite a bit for work and wasn't home that often, so that configuration made sense at the time. Now that I'm working from home full time and all my business and personal travel plans have been canceled, I was inspired to build my own PC after Superman Henry Cavill built his. I bought all the parts on that build and took the RTX 2070 Super out of the eGPU and into the NZXT chassis. So let's take a look at the configuration and costs of both systems. The MacBook Pro 16 is running a 9th gen Intel Core i9-9900 CPU, AMD 5500 8GB video memory with 32GB of RAM, 2TB of SSD storage, and connected to an Akito node with an RTX 2070 Super. The cost of this setup is $3,899 for the laptop alone, plus $200 for the Akito node, and an additional $499 for the RTX 2070, which totals at a whopping $4,598. That's $4,598. Holy crap. I didn't realize how much I spent on all that till now. Let me take a second to let that sink in. Okay, the specs for the PC I just built is running a 10th gen Intel i7-10700K, 32GB RAM at 3200MHz, 1TB SSD drive, and the same NVIDIA RTX 2070 Super transferred from that eGPU. The total cost for this build would be about $1,800 for all the parts that I use. I'll include a link in the description for that build. Now, this isn't really a true apples to apple comparison, because obviously one is a laptop and the other is a desktop, but the specs are very similar, and the 9th gen Core i9 runs close to the 10th gen Core i7 that's on the desktop though. Let's take a look at some scores. The games are at max or ultra settings with RTX on, displaying to a 3440 by 1440 screen. After running the Tomb Raider benchmark, I thought the scores would be similarly close across the board at a 9.5 to 10% variance, but to my surprise, they are not. For Modern Warfare, running the RTX 2070 Super was 55% faster on the desktop. Control was over 200% faster on the desktop, and the 3DMark scores on TimeSpy and FireStrike were 30% and 60% faster on the desktop. Remember, the price of the MacBook Pro 16-inch with an eGPU will run you close to $4,600, whereas a gaming desktop will be $1,800. You can easily build two desktops and have a bunch of money left over for games. The bandwidth limitations of Thunderbolt 3 really takes a hit on gaming performance, and you don't use the full potential of the video card with an eGPU. Now, obviously, the logic makes sense if your purpose for owning a computer is mainly for games, and you don't factor in the needs for portability, day-to-day software needs, and other reasons. Before building my desktop, I was gaming on a 16-inch Mac and a eGPU because my job requires me to work in both operating systems. Now I'm working from home full-time, and I have to admit, building that PC was just so satisfying. So let me know what you guys think by dropping a comment on the video. A like is always appreciated, and I'm grateful for everyone who subscribes. So please stay safe, and please be kind to each other during these times. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.